Hey, what's up guys? Today we are going to create a production-ready MLFLow setup for sharing your work results with your teammates. If you ever wondered how to centralize machine learning in your organization, the MLFLow surely is a good step. But first things first, what exactly is MLFLow and how does it work? MLFLow gathers metrics from your code, runs your code in a deterministic way using Anaconda, and stores all your models on your local or shared machine for other contributors. Its architecture looks like that. As you can see from the diagram above, we need to set up a tracking server with a database, an artifact store, and a client side for running Python scripts. To get started with the installation, we will need just two things: a workstation with Python and optionally Miniconda 3 or Anaconda 3 installed, and the virtual machine with public IP. It can be Linux or Windows. I'm assuming that you already completed the first requirement to install Python on your machine. Let's move on to the server-side requirements. We need a virtual machine hosted anywhere you like. For this project, I'm going to use Azure Virtual Machine, but you are free to host it on AWS, DigitalOcean, or your data center. We need public IP for the machine and optionally the DNS configuration. Today I will skip the DNS configuration part because it varies hugely depending on your internet domain name's provider. Just ask your infrastructure administrator. If you already have a virtual machine, SSH into it and skip to the part of this video shown on the screen right now. Now I'm going to log in into portal.azure.com and I'm going to click create a resource. I'm going to use Ubuntu Server 18. And the setup is as simple as creating a new resource group. I'm going to name it MLFLow and give the virtual machine a name and create a password. Be sure to check the price, obviously. You can always try a smaller machine with like one virtual CPU or less memory, but I'm going to stay with that. Let's click next and wait for the VM to create after you accept the configuration. As you can see, the VM is going to deploy soon. I'm going to skip the waiting process for you. Okay, the VM creation process is complete. Let's go to the VM by clicking Go to Resource. As you can see, I've got the MLFLow tutorial virtual machine up and running, and now I'm going to configure the networking. You need to go to this networking tab and go to Add Port Rule. Enter the 5000 port and name it MLFLow S3 bucket. Click add and then create another one with the port 9000. Make sure that you use different priority other than your already existing rules. And give it a name. Let's wait for the creation process. And as you can see, we've got the two open ports. That's the end of the virtual machine preparation. Now, let's open up a terminal and log in into the virtual machine. To SSH into your virtual machine, go to the Overview tab and copy the public IP. Now let's go into your terminal, type in SSH, your username that you selected in the virtual machine creation process, and the IP of the machine. Type in yes and enter your password. As you can see, I'm logged in into my virtual machine Ubuntu 18. The first task on this machine is to install Docker. go to the Docker installation instruction and follow it. The link is in the video description. You just have to copy and paste the setup the repository section and install Docker Engine. That process might take a while, like 2 or 3 minutes. So don't worry. When the installation is complete, you can test the installation by running sudo docker run hello world. If everything is working fine, you will see an instruction for the Docker newbies. Now we can move on and install Docker Compose. Again, the link is in the video description. It's much shorter, you just have to copy and paste these two commands. Let's copy and paste. Copy and paste. Let's begin the MLFLow installation. The first thing we need to do is to clone the repository from the GitHub. So type in git clone and then we are going to copy the address from the GitHub repository here. The link to this repository is also in the description below. So click copy and then just paste it in. As you can see, it's done. Now there will be a new folder on your home directory. CD into it. And we've got all the files needed. Now we will need to edit the .env file. I'm gonna use nano. And you can change the AWS access key for whatever you want. And you can also change AWS secret access key for whatever you want. I'm gonna leave other things as they are and exit the application by clicking Ctrl X and then clicking yes and enter. The last command that we need to run is to type in docker compose app-d. It will start all the infrastructure needed for the MLFLow to run correctly. And as you can see, we have to run docker compose with sudo. Everything is going to be downloaded and then it will run just fine. Hopefully. Now we will configure the S3 minio bucket. For that to work, we'll need to install minio using pip 3, install minio. And as you can see, we need to install first the pip. So install it. Type in yes. Now we can install our minio using pip 3. Okay, now it's successfully installed. We can use source.env to load our environment configuration. And now let's run the final script. Bash run create bucket. And if everything is okay, there will be no error message. As you can see, there is no. So everything is done correctly. Now we can move to our browser and type in the IP from the Azure portal. I'm going to copy the public IP and paste it in the browser with the port 9000. There's our Minio server. Hooray! And what about our MLFLow on the 5000 port? It's up and running. Now we can test the final configuration on our developer machine. But to do this, we'll need to first configure it by just copying the configuration from our server. You can do this by using my script bash rc generate and just copy and paste that configuration from this terminal into your developer machine. I'm going to switch to my local machine terminal using git bash. I'm going to edit my bash rc file inside my home directory. I'm gonna paste the configuration, and the one thing that we need to change here is to replace the localhost part with the actual public IP of your virtual machine. Again, the public IP can be found on your virtual machine page here. Just copy the IP and paste it here. The same thing happens here. Now we can save the file. As you can see, that's how my file looks. Now we can source it. Source just loads that environment variables. And now we can just install MLFLow library into our computer because we need one using pip3. And now we can just run the test experiment here. If it's giving you an error, like just like me, you can try to run this command with no conda switch because there's something wrong with my mini conda 3 package on my computer. But the Python one just works, as you can see here. Succeeded. Now we can find our artifacts. So our like results of our program in the MLFLow UI. If I get just refresh the page, as you can see, there's the first run when something wrong happened in my mini conda 3 environment, and the second just 20 seconds after the successful run, we've got the parameters, the metrics, and the most problematic one, artifacts. And as you can see, we've got working files just right there. That's it, guys. I hope everything is now clear to you. If that is the case, please leave a like or a comment down below. This is just the first video from MLFLow, so stay tuned.